Motherlist。我们要隆重地邀请到呢加拿大 Alberta 大学药品及制药科学系的教授Dr. Rama Lobenberg。
So, ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, we'd like to invite Dr. Rama Lobenberg。
他的这个主题呢是关于大麻，我们应该知道什么？
So the topic of his speech is cannabis.What should we know about it? So, Dr. Rama Lobenberg is a professor of University of Alberta. He is an expert and a license holder in cannabis research, formulation, development, and production. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Lobenberg, please.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction. I want to thank the organizers.Give me the opportunity to talk this afternoon. And as you see in my talk here, and my apologies, my Chinese is not sufficient. I could do it in German maybe, but that will not help either. So I stay with English. So marijuana, what should we know about it? This is what I wanted to talk about this afternoon. And before I do this, I wanted to give you some pictures of the University of Alberta.Yeah, okay. Okay, we found it on the spot translator.
我做一些翻译哈，大家是大家可以可以明白啊。关键的是。
So, as you can see, Alberta is green sometimes. This is our lab.And we get a lot of international visitors from China, for example, but also from the Caribbean, and we do clinical trial material production. As you know, October 17, everybody thought Canada will go up in smoke. It didn't happen, not in this way. And this is the lab infrastructure we have. Dan showed you chromatograms, how with these peaks,These kind of machines do these peaks. You can get them out and get them on the.
Can I translate this one? 这个是我们 Dr. Lobenberg laboratory. 刚刚金这个我们金丹这个博士也介绍很多工作也是在这里做的，就是包括一些 HPLC 那些化学分析的一些设备，还有提取设备。
So price tag on such a machine is around $400,000.
就这一个机器40多万，
Here the licenses we at the moment hold after the changes, so we have a license to test for cannabis, and we have a license to do research on cannabis.
Dr. Lobenberg 呢，他是加拿大卫生部，他不仅仅是一个做科研的教授，他卫生部呢要做研究大麻产品，应用大麻也需要有执照的。他是一个很少就是这个卫生部。分布的，他就是给大家看了，就是他的研究，还有这个提取大麻执照。
So, now to cannabis. You are mostly from China, and you know Chinese used cannabis as a traditional plant for many, many centuries. It was used because for ropes, for textiles, paper, but also for nutrition, the oil, and of course.For sacramental and recreational use. There was only recently that cannabis was classified as an illegal drug and came now in Canada at least back into legal status. And it started in the end with first with opium in the early 1900s, 1911. And then in 1923, they just added cannabis to opium. They had not much idea about even the chemistry of these plants, but must be bad, you know, impairs like opium, so they put it on, and only lately, now in October 17 last year, it got legal again.
实际上，大麻这个变成禁药哈、啊，毒品啊，实际上是很短的历史。刚刚他说的那么长的历史都是合法化的，就是在大概是这个世纪的上世纪的初期吧，那个时候变成了禁药，把它归为鸦片的一类的。实际上Dr. Obam 说很多东西也是没有道理的，其实根本不知道它的化学成分啊什么都没有搞清楚。直到最近呢，我们就是开始各个国家，特别是加拿大的这个 legalization 就变成合法化。
In the US, we had the situation that in the 1970s, the government produced reports saying legalize cannabis, but Nixon did the opposite. He put it on Schedule 1, and Schedule 1 substances have no medical use and are highly potential for abuse. And I think we know nowadays that's not totally right. So, and then in the 1980s came a report out where from the government in the US saying that marijuana is far safer than many foods we commonly consume. If you eat 10 potatoes uncooked, you get intoxication. You can't eat enough cannabis to kill yourself.
这个挺有意思的，他就说在美国的话，这个很极端的。1972年的时候呢，他的这个就是Attorney General 就基本上就是把这个变本加厉的把这个大麻呢就列为这种 Schedule 1，基本上 Schedule 1的话是一点作用都没有，一点好处都没有的，就变成一个毒品的。1972年的时候，80年代的时候呢，就开始又放松了一点，因为那些有些科学根据就出来了。实际上有科研人家就科学研究就说呢，实际上这个大麻吃大麻呢比很多食物都还要安全。就说比如说你吃了十个 potato， 你可能十个这个生的这个土豆，你可能会中毒，你吃大麻不会中毒，就是有这样的一个反应在80年代的时候。
As we know, 2018, here's a map of Canada, how many facilities existed who could legally now produce cannabis. You see Ontario's 57, when we now look, 2019 already, and this was April 88, so the cannabis industry is growing very, very fast in North America.
现在大家看了，就是加拿大自从合法化以后哈，基本上你看这张图，就是说，现在很多地方这个是就是种植的哈，在西部，比如说 BC 省有三十九个公司啊，39个 farm 都在种植，然后安大略省现在是88个。
And the government, of course, saw that they can make taxes out of it.
那政府肯定是有好处的，它因为合法化以后，它可以收很多税了，收很多税。
And now worldwide, as we see here in this map, where people begin to legalize marijuana, and this opens, of course, finally for us as researchers, access to the plants, and for clinicians that they can now make clinical trial. Before it was very, very difficult to do research on this plant.
现在看现在大麻合法化是全球性的，实际上我们特别的欣慰，作为一个搞科研的，对吧？像以前合法化之前呢，它不仅仅说是民用、实用都不行，它就包括不能让你科研人员也不能做实验，也不能去做研究，做临床实验是根本不可能的。所以现在呢，是我们可以对我们做科研人员来说呢，也是一个很好的一个就是 legalization 也是个很好的一个消息。
Legalization came in Canada also. Worldwide, marijuana is one of the most trafficked illegal drugs. $7 billion is this estimated, and of course the enforcement of marijuana laws cost a lot of money, and this was also one of the reasons why the Canadian government chose to legalize the drug. Here's the statistics.
对，其实最早刚刚那张图的话，实际上这个大麻非法化的时候呢，是造成的经济损失，直接损失的话是70个亿，就是因为地下种植这些，还有更大的一个东西是社会的影响，这些犯罪啊，社会的活动，这个警察啊，我们用的这些钱，用于这些legal 这个法律的这个东西，是对社会的话，这个也是造成的影响还有损失非常大。
So 2011, I have the statistics: 113,000 crimes and 54% was for marijuana possession. There you can see the amount this enforcement takes on resources.
举这个例子，就犯罪率多高多高，就跟大麻有关了，就不一定。
It is very interesting. I heard that one of the biggest lobby groups in the United States opposing marijuana legislation is the private prison industry.
这个也是犯罪的，在美国的话，其实最多的进监狱的人都是跟大麻是有关的。
Of course, who is taking marijuana? Here's statistics: the 15 to 17 year old young people, probably.Some try it and it seems not to be picking up, but the 25 to 50 to 44 and then the people 45 to 64, they have quite increases in the last years in marijuana. So we have to see after the after it got legalized, what will happen to the young people? Will they increase the consumption of marijuana or not? Because we know also if you are taking it too young, it has.Neurological consequences.
他这张统计的话是根据这个年龄的，是在过去的十年中是是在这个十年这多少年六五年到二零幺五年的，它是一个各个年龄组的一个趋势。实际上他刚刚说的话就是说这个不好管理。实际上这个大麻的话，就是因为研究数字很少嘛，实际上对青少年的话，实际上有些你要说坏处的影响是青少年的，这个他们的影响是最大的。
What is very interesting is probably this study from the 1994, where there was a comparison between withdrawal, reinforcement tolerance, dependence, intoxication, addiction potential between different substances. Look at nicotine, heroin, cocaine, alcohol, caffeine, and cannabis. And when we looked into this data, in most categories, cannabis is much less dangerous than even caffeine.So I think cannabis was probably one of the plants which was really wrongly classified for the wrong reasons for a long, long time. But I will show this also a little bit later. Cannabis is not totally harmless.
这张图是很有意思，这是多年的这一个统计的结果。最后那一组图的话是 cannabis， 就是它就是根据这些毒品啊，就是nicotine。尼古丁、海洛因、这个 cocaine、海洛因，还有这些非常毒的。最后那两个呢是 alcohol， 就是说酒精跟咖啡因的比较，就造成的这些社会问题，还有这些